Hey, welcome everybody. In today's video, I'll go over the whole design process of this landing page using Adobe XD. Let's start by taking a quick look over the content, break it down into sections, and jump into Dribbble to find some inspiration. Since this is done for a financial app that helps young people get ready for retirement, I'll search for that and open every shot that I like in a new tab. To bring everything together, I'm using Milanote, which is the place where I gather inspiration and create mood boards. I'll drag a new board over here, and name it Paragon Landing Page, since that's the name of the company I'm doing this for. Double click to access it, and following that, I'll go in each tab I just opened up, hit right click and select copy image, then paste it in the board. Once I've done that with every single one, just drag them on your canvas. This is kind of like a pin board, so I'll have to reposition each element to my liking, and usually I arrange the ones I prefer at the very top. Milanote also has image search built in, so I can find images from Unsplash without having to leave my board, which is pretty cool. If I click on add image and tap in mountains, then I can get some imagery that will set the tone for my landing page. Once I'm done, I'll either place captions or notes with what I like about my favorite ones and what I can apply to my own design. If you'd like to sign up for Milanote for free and give it a shot, you should find a link in the description. And of course, help this channel out. You can also get 20% off Milanote Pro Forever using the coupon code Cosmin20. Now I'm ready to jump into Adobe XD, select a web document to start with. This already has a full HD view, and now I'll rename the artboard by double clicking at the top, let's say Paragon page, and enable the grid, which should be on the right hand side. I'll use everything but the two columns on the sides. I'm doing this design on the MacBook touchpad, so pinch to zoom out and adjust the canvas by dragging on the handle here. Haven't had time to talk to you about the company I'm doing this for. Paragon is an app that helps you save up money for retirement, and they're about to launch a Kickstarter campaign. This is their logo. I just have the file on a separate monitor, so I just dragged it and added the SVG file automatically. Place it at the top for now, and I'll bring the rest of the colors in. I'll have to do small adjustments for it to fit here. And in order to start saving up the colors, you'll need to disable the grid layout first to make things easier and either select an item or use the eyedropper tool to sample each color, and on the left hand side, click on the plus button from the colors tab. I saved each different one in the panel and placed my first text element, hit D and click anywhere on the canvas. Paste in the content for the main headline and give it a color, let's say this gray, only because I need to have a dark background. I'll take the rectangle tool and create a shape for the background. Once I've placed it, I'll make sure that the fill is navy blue and deselect the border styling. You have full control of the actual size of the shape, and once you're happy, go to the layers panel that's at the bottom here and set that layer to the back. I'll do some small adjustments, but this shape will probably cover the whole canvas in the end. We'll want to set a different font for the headline. Once you have selected it, on the right hand side you should see the options panel and use the one called Rubik. Since it's a headline, I'll go with the bold font weight and give it a size of 40 pixels. I haven't drawn a bounding box for it, I'll have to manually break it down into several lines. Maybe there's an easier way to do it, but this is actually the first landing page I'm designing in Adobe XD, so if there are any cool shortcuts I missed, maybe just let me know in the comment section below. I've held down the Alt key and duplicated the element. Let's give it a 20 pixel size and adjust the weight of the font, maybe have it light, and paste in the content for the sub headline. I'll break it down in three separate lines, and using the select tool, I'll play around and reposition it. Maybe have it closer to the headline. At this point, there are two main character styles, so to save them, just select each one and go on the left hand side and hit the plus icon. Now you can reuse them at any point. It's time to have a button underneath, so not doing anything too crazy right now. This is a pretty basic layout, but the elements I'm about to create is what will make it stand out, hopefully. I'll start with the phone mockup on the right hand side instead of using what is pre-made. I'll create it out of shapes. Once I place the first rectangle, I'll round up the numbers for the dimensions and play a bit with the corner radius. First, let's zoom in a bit and disable the grid to have a better look on what we're doing. And on the right hand side, you should see a field where you can enter the corner radius. For this shape, I'll have 30 pixels. Then go ahead and duplicate the shape in order to create the screen, and of course do some resizing. The phone needs a notch at the top, and if you'd like to have more control on each corner, hold down the Alt key and click and drag this handle. That will give you individual control over any anchor point you'd like. Once I'm happy with something, I'll try to do the same thing on the other side as well. We'll zoom out now and get ready to create some triangles behind all of these elements. Using the pen tool, we can start from the left hand side and go up with an anchor right about there, and then have it behind the phone. Somewhere around this place should be good. Then close down the shape. I'll want to give it a gradient fill. For that, make sure that the shape is selected. Disable the border and click once on the color. At the top, you should have three different options for this shape. I'll have a linear gradient. Select each endpoint. And using the eyedropper tool, I'll sample the colors I have saved up in the panel on the left. I'll do something with the light and dark blue and adjust the way it's getting rendered through these points, through moving them. Since we're using the same color as the background, I really like the effect where it kind of fades out on the left side. In the layers panel, I'll find it and drag it behind the other elements to make it visible. Even though I like the position of the triangle, I like to give it rounded corners, and since there's no easy way of doing it, unlike Illustrator, I'll place a circle at both ends and create a new shape on top of it. Okay, would also like to have a diagonal shape behind everything, so using the pen tool, I'll draw something. There's no specific angle, just do what feels right. I'll use the same gradient style, lower the opacity of the triangle a bit just to give everything a bit of depth. One feature I really like with Adobe XD is the fact that I can drag an image on top of any shape and it will be masked automatically. We'll want to play a bit with using the same image behind the phone as well, so there's something unique about the header. To do that, I'll duplicate the diagonal shape, drag and drop the image again, and now in order to have control over its position, all you have to do is double click on that shape. Hold down the Shift key to make sure that the ratio remains the same and drag from either corners to make it smaller. You can then click outside to deselect it. Right now it's a bit too big. But before that, let me select the phone shape and maybe give it a different color. The navy blue should work just fine. Getting back to the image, I'll need to try a few things as I want the one from the phone to work seamlessly with the one in the background. Not sure if I can control the opacity of this image when I place it, would be really helpful. Right now, I'm just making guesses on what is the right position. I think it's closer, but it needs to move down a bit. As you can tell, this can get pretty annoying real fast. There must be a better way of doing it, but maybe I just don't know it. I think it's close enough for now. I'll have to look for that layer and place it behind the initial diagonal shape. Now duplicate the initial one, and we'll have a gradient with one point being transparent, so I can mask the left side of the image where it cuts out. Select the lighter end, and next to the eyedropper tool, you can adjust the opacity level of that point. We'll give it 0% and move it around till I'm happy with the result. As I said, this is the first time I've used Adobe XD to design anything, and so far it's been pretty straightforward. As a first impression, it works great. Love how snappy everything is. I love dealing with artboards, and when I'm creating new elements, there is no lag. I'd be curious to see though how it deals with multiple artboards, but maybe in another video. Next to the phone, I've created some shapes where I'll place a couple of icons I've downloaded from Envato Elements. I'll also reuse the triangle shape in other sections as well. I sped up this video since it took me a couple of hours to complete the layout, and I'm not sure if you have a couple of hours to watch me work. A couple of good tips: from time to time I'll enable and disable the grid just to make sure that everything is properly aligned. As I'm doing this landing page, I'm not even sure Adobe XD should be used for it. I still prefer Photoshop because, well, you can create something more unique. But I guess this is the direction most design tools are heading towards, and it's honestly refreshing to watch how it will change the way designers create new things. For me, it's been a while since Sketch started becoming popular, and I'm happy to have to learn a new tool. I'm always checking YouTube for new tutorials. It kind of reminds me of the days when I discovered Photoshop and watched every tutorial I could get my hands on. If you have time, I'd recommend checking out Cody Brown and Keller Edwards. they have some dope videos on Adobe XD, and that's where I learned all of the shortcuts I'm using right now. With the icons, I have them in an SVG document, so I just dragged it on the artboard and copy and pasted it one in the appropriate shape. Then I'll just remove the other ones I won't use. I've left the form at the bottom of the page, the messaging as visitor to sign up for the newsletter in order to get notified when the app launches. So I'll move the button to the right hand side and create a rectangle next to it, which will actually be the form field. I'll make it 370 pixels in width and try to match the corner radius with the button. I'll select the button first to see how many pixels it has and go back and apply the same value. Now, I think I've messed up here because I've duplicated an element that's part of the symbol, the button, and it applied the same thing to the bottom at the top, but I'll just remove it afterwards. Let's put in your email address and do some small adjustments before taking a look at the page. This is the final design of the landing page. Hope you've enjoyed this video. If you did, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe for more. Till next time, take care everybody. Bye. Thank you.